Are you having difficulty in understanding and remembering the accounting equation? Today, I will help you to understand it, and stay tuned to the end of the video for my easy to understand formula and also an interesting example for you. Stay tuned! Hi entrepreneurs, I'm Sharon and you're watching Nuts Accounting, where accounting is as easy as nuts. This channel is all about helping online entrepreneurs and small business owners to do your own accounts and grow your business. If you are new here, subscribe and click the bell button for more videos like this. Accounting equation is usually taught as one of the first few topics in accounting classes. It is very important that you fully understand and master this. Today, I am going to help you to build a strong foundation in accounting so that all other accounting principles will be not so easy for you. Accounting equation is assets equals with liabilities plus equity. Remember that you will need to keep this balance at all times, no matter how many number of transactions that you have recorded. The equation is quite long and it's not easy to remember, right? And so, here comes my easy to remember formula. One alphabet is all you need. Yes, it's super easy to just remember one alphabet. So, get your notes, pens and papers. No, you don't need that. Just one alphabet, you don't need to write it down. Okay, just remember this. The alphabet of O. It's just one O. Ah, it looks like a hazelnut. If you think this formula is easy and you can remember it, give me an O in the comments below. So what do I mean by O? Now let's see. All the things that you own is equals to all the things that you owe. This is what it means by just one alphabet of O. There's O at both sides, own and owed. Alright? If you would like to learn more on assets and liabilities, you may check out my other videos that I will put the link in the description for you. Assets such like cash and car is what your business owned. Liabilities is what your business owed to third parties. Example of this is your creditors and also your bank loan. Equity arises from the capital introduced by the owners of the business and from retained profit. In other words, equity is what the business owed to its owners. To keep things interesting for you, let's walk through the story of Rachel's startup. As the business is brand new and Rachel just started it, the business does not own or owe anything at all at the moment. It's zero. So, Rachel started the online store and then she opens a bank account for her business and deposited $1,000 from her own money. When this transaction takes place, what the business owns, which is the balance in the bank account, will increase by $1,000 while the business is currently owing Rachel for her money that she has borrowed to the business of $1,000, which is the capital. All you in the column of the equity. So right now, what the business owns is $1,000 and what it owes is $1,000. So it is equals. It remains balanced. And next, she set up her online store and it is now up and running. She paid $500 for this. So what happens to the business accounting equation? What the business owns is reduced by $500. While what the business owe is reduced by $500 as well. And next, she made a purchase with a 30 days credit term from a clothing supplier of $200. This means she will take the clothes first and pay the supplier within 30 days. So in the accounting equation, the amount that the business owns increased by $200, while the amount that the business owe is increased by $200 as well, because now it is owing money to the creditor. 1 week later, she made her first sales online. She sold one piece at $40 and her cost is $20. So in this example, there is two things that happen. The first transaction that happened is her sales of $40, while the second transaction that happens is her cost of $20. So let's look at the first one. When she made her sales, her bank account increases by $40, which is what she owns. And meanwhile, her sales, which is her equity, will increase by $40 as well as what she owes. So this accounting equation is still balanced, 40 on both sides. The second transaction, which is the inventory transaction, is reduced by $20 because that's the cost of her clothes, which reduces what she owns at the moment. And meanwhile, her cost of goods sold, which falls under the category of her equity, will reduce by $20 as well. Now it's time for Rachel to review the accounts and see the performance of her business. The business owns $720 and meanwhile, the business owes $720 as well. The amounts on both sides are equal and balanced. Always remember, no matter how many number of transactions that you have recorded in your accounts, the accounting equation must always remain equal and balanced at all times. That was my easy to remember formula, and I hope you fully understand the accounting equation. Now, I would love to hear from you. Do you have any secret formula to remember the accounting equation? Do you have any accounting questions or accounting topics that you would like to learn? Join in the conversation with fellow entrepreneurs in the comment section of this video. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. If you want more awesome resources and be the first to know of my latest content, sign up for my email newsletter at nutscounting.com. Let's go nuts about accounting to grow your business. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time at Nuts Accounting. Bye-bye.